Hello, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. If you're just getting started with mobile music production on iOS, then the terms inter-app audio and audio unit version 3 might leave you feeling a bit confused. In this video, I'll explain a bit about these audio connection methods and share some pros and cons of both. Released in 2013 alongside iOS 7, inter-app audio is Apple's answer to AudioBus. Before inter-app audio launched, if you were making music on iOS, AudioBus was most probably a huge part of your workflow. Essentially, AudioBus is a standalone app that allows installed and compatible apps to send audio to one another. The attraction of inter-app audio over AudioBus is that it's already built into the OS. There's no need to pay for and download a separate app. In GarageBand, you can find a list of inter-app audio apps in the external sounds section of the sound browser. Tap on inter-app audio and choose from any inter-app audio compatible apps that you have installed. You'll be taken to the audio recorder where you can see a small icon depicting the inter-app audio app that you have loaded. Tapping this icon will switch from GarageBand's interface to your app's interface, and there'll be a button present in the app's interface to switch back. You can switch to different apps by tapping the jack icon and tapping the inter-app audio tab. One of the biggest things that inter-app audio has going for it is the amount of compatible apps that you can use with it. It's a massive list, giving you a lot of options when it comes to choosing instruments and effect sounds. You can only have one instance of an inter-app audio app loaded on a track at any time though, which does limit your ability to add multiple external effects or load multiple instances of the same app on a track. For me, the inter-app audio implementation in GarageBand for iOS is a bit clunky too. I'm not really a big fan of having to switch back and forth between app interfaces when trying to record or edit projects. It's a bit of a faff, really. Introduced in 2015 with the release of iOS 9, audio units, audio unit extensions, audio unit version 3, whatever you want to call it, will seem very familiar to anyone who has used GarageBand, or Logic Pro for that matter, on Mac. Mobile music makers no longer have to rely on what some would consider clunky solutions like AudioBus or inter-app audio. Instead, apps can simply be run from within your preferred iOS DAW, just as they would on the desktop platform. The last year to 18 months has seen an explosion in the number of AUv3 apps available, both new apps and updated versions of old favourites, which is good news. In GarageBand, you'll be adding your AUv3 app to an existing track within a project. On the track screen, tap the Track Controls button and tap on Plugins and EQ. Tap Edit in the top right of the window and tap a green plus icon. To add an AUv3 app to the slot, tap the Audio Unit Extension tab to select from any Audio Unit version 3 apps you have installed, or Apple's own serviceable but decidedly beige offerings. The beauty of Audio Unit version 3 apps is that they can be loaded directly into a host app, which makes it much easier to change settings quickly. This gets rid of the need to switch between apps. This method also results in far less strain on your CPU. There are reports of users finding that recording and editing on their older iOS devices is a lot snappier and they see less instances of the dreaded optimizing performance message when using AUv3 over inter-app audio. You can load multiple instances of the same app on a single track too. This is a significant advantage that AUv3 has over inter-app audio. At the time of recording, there isn't quite as many Audio Unit version 3 apps available as there are ones that are compatible with inter-app audio, but with the meteoric rise of AUv3 over the last 12 months and it quickly becoming the preferred method of linking audio among musicians and developers alike, the list of Audio Unit version 3 hosts, instruments and effects will continue to grow and grow. So it's pretty obvious which of these methods I personally prefer. AUv3 simply makes life easier. It makes creating projects simpler and my workflow more streamlined. Inter-app audio was a useful workaround solution, but definitely of its time. And it's clear to me at least that Audio Unit version 3 is the future of music making on iOS. So there you have it, in the battle of inter-app audio versus Audio Unit version 3, there has emerged a clear winner, in my opinion at least. What do you think? Have I set myself up for a world of pain in the comments section? Only time will tell. I've been Patrick from thegaragebandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.